Okay. Now, I got a key. So what's the story with this room? So, you enter from that room, I guess. Hell. Okay. Let's look at that again. Okay, so why is there a door here? That must be stairs. Yeah. I guess there must be stairs there. Okay, I almost got this whole map figured out. Okay, that's an exit of some kind. I guess from that room, so. And this must be an exit as well. So, there's two entrances here, so, it's down here, which I need to, room right for. So, I have no reason anymore to be on this floor, except for healing. Screw off, man! Just sitting there. It's not horrible, but, oh man, it's, when it comes to complexity, but, I was there saying in the last, video, it's like, I goes, no, Evan doesn't like wind, he doesn't like using wind, but he doesn't mind using this fucking, arrow path that always takes you back to this fucking room. No, you don't mind wind, but you don't mind, having a player just sit there like, ugh, he just watched himself helplessly get drift back to this room over and over again. You know, you don't want win. No, win. Yeah, no, you're winless. No, what we got going on here? One of the last things I did was this. Which, you're gonna fucking die, you know? Talking to Owl, by the way. speaking of the owl room, that's exactly where I want to go right now. I think. Yeah, this is new. And that's a locked door. Well, what's the point of this room? Can I just walk? Oh, no, I can't just walk that. Okay. It also doesn't interrupt gameplay, as in, like, one thing about an actual game over is, I'll say, for example, like AVG Adventures, when you die, you'll get a game over screen, but the music still goes. Therefore, the gameplay still feels continuous. One thing about Wind, I find, is that it doesn't break the gameplay that way. It sends you back to the beginning level, but you're still in the game. So that's why Wind has never bothered me. But the whole game over thing, you go to the game over screen, and then you gotta click continue. When you die, it feels like you're sent out of the game. But when you're hit with the wind don't bother me that way. Oh! Oh yeah, but that's the evilness of that's the evilness. What do you think Bush likes it so much? Why do you think Moosh loves wind so damn much? Fuck. Fuck. Oh, jeez, no, I will agree with you on that one. Oh, okay, what am I doing? Gauntlets is... That's the thing about gauntlets, too. There's nothing more annoying than getting very far in a gauntlet and then having to do it all over again. Fuck. Shit. Which is, he's he's a character. Well, that's not a bad thing. I'd rather have a character than a non-character. Whatever that meant. I'm a character. Yeah, you just have to be out there, don't you? Gal Boomerang. Guide this path by holding down the button. It's assigned to powerful ghosts. It creates short circuit and gunpoint. It's been stung. Okay, sounds good. Counterclockwise. Okay. Just practicing, don't mind me. That's good design. Just letting you know. Yeah. But people... And some people would do that, but that's one thing that's annoying about F6. But yeah, that's good design. When you... It's like that Ego Raptor video. If you can teach people how to use an item without using words, you're doing a good job. Like in one of my quests, there's nothing obvious in Triforce. Actually, there's nothing telling you that there's you can actually use, like, you use hookshot on certain blocks, but nothing tells you you can use it on certain statues as well. So I have this one screen. If you walk into, you'll see a Goria shoot a hookshot, and he hit the statue, and then there's like a little funny thing where he just spins right out and then falls down. But some people could see the humor of that, but other people could actually see that. It's like, oh, you can hookshot to that. It's meant to be both a humorous thing and a little teaching thing at the same time. There's things like that I'm playing around with now. Rather, I prefer teaching through your design more than words any day. Now, okay, so I got the boomerang now, so let's go to some places with the... When you're saying you're so sorry, that's worrying me. Oh, yes, that's right. I was about to say, I didn't know what you were saying, sorry, too, but... How the hell did I just do that? What the hell? There are times when using words is an escape clause. Yeah, I know what you mean. With more complex mechanics, but simple things can usually be intuitively figured out. The biggest thing, yes. And sometimes just giving, sometimes like, it depends on like what you want to pick. There's nothing too horrible about using words to teach a player to. As long as it's not a hell of a lot of words. I think it's a preferable approach to let players learn through seeing it. It's all a matter of picking and choosing, depending on the circumstances. And yes, you're right, as long as the dev understands it. Now, I should be safe there now. Oh yeah. Now. So I just go through this room, through the stairs. Even in that beta, there's a lot of things I still feel like I gotta fix, but overall, there's some rooms that are just awkwardly done, but that's the nature of being a beta too. But I'm very confident in how it's going. I'll put it that way. It's going rather smoothly. For the most part, I hope you're not too disappointed. The first level hasn't been changed much, except the Staphos. I don't know if you remember the first beta. The Staphos took forever to kill, but I changed that. I created a new enemy. I gotta do something about that. Hookshot dynamic anyways. I haven't fully figured out yet, but I created the weaker enemies for the hookshot. Well, essentially the hookshot's not supposed to be the main weapon. That's where a lot of people got confused with that. But I'm working things out now. Now, while I'm on the subject. Wait, why is that key? This map is a bit messed up. That shouldn't be there. Either way. As long as I know the difference. Or should be there. No, I've been. I don't know. Okay, where am I? Okay, so that's the place that I need to go. Any place I can easily go to now? Yeah, that's it there. So let's do that. I'm getting a bit better with the boomerang. A little bit. I just started using it. Yeah. This is not there. Fuck you, I gotta get you guys over there first. You guys are getting on my nerves. Yeah. Actually, I gotta do that whole fucking room again. I know I do. I know I do. Oh man, I do. Oh, thank God. Thank God. If you had that room set to enemies always return, I would have been so fucking pissed off with you. I think I just gave you an idea. Why am I going back down here again? No! That was a new place! I was at a new place! Why? Why did I go down here in the first place? Just to get the skull? I guess that's it. I guess that's the only reason to go down there. Oh, now there's that. It's the fucking owl. Because no, you don't have to walk back from the owl. I think it's the right way. I got it all pretty much memorized now. Why the hell have I got that this equipped? Oh. Oh yeah, this, what about, what's the story with this thing? Ah. Oh, okay. I got to do, yeah, okay, good enough. Thank you. No, I do not. I've had a little bit tough. And I want to just get to this level and get done over with. So maybe after I do this level, I'll get to the fucking dead wallet. But then again, isn't there an item in level... in the desert level that make that easier? Pocket King was rough. I'll be the first to say that. Still having hard trouble with this item. That two candles is different than the rest. That's significant for... I do, and I like the sound of doing that. And I do this, and, and I get another key! Yeah! Press F6. Just seems like a lot easier. Yeah, I enjoyed that. Just letting you know, most people already know I can't whistle. Even though I keep trying. I'll forever keep trying this. Okay, that'll go down there now, so what's the entrance to this? Oh, okay. So I gotta find a... Damn. So I'm... going back down somehow. How do I get that treasure chest there? I guess I'll figure it out after. Sure, the first time I... Well, you also gotta take account into idle time, too. Like, I've been pressing F6 more this quest. Well, wait time, I should say. I've been pressing F6, not F6, F3 more this time. But still, there's been many times I didn't press it. But Jesus Christ, the first time I beat this game was over 70 hours. And to be honest, I think I've discussed before, I think I'm rather slower than most people when it comes to Zelda Classic, because I just got this compulsive need to kill everything I see. I just love the feeling of, like, defeating enemies. I just love it. Well, how quickly can you beat it? I would take my time and at least double it. Like, if I could beat the quest in 10 hours, well, at least double it. Yeah, again, I'm a little slow, because I have a compulsive need to kill everything I see. So don't mind me being a little bit slow in this game. I'm slow with almost every quest. Wow. So, let's see. Now, what we got going on here? Remember, the first time I beat this, I had over 70 hours. 70 hours! Like, trying to imagine, over 70 hours! I still don't know to this day, how it could possibly take me over 70 hours to beat the game, but... Well, that's what it was. I'm still trying to figure out what in the world made me take over 70 hours, right? But no, it's... I'm just not the fastest with Zelda Classic. I think it is. And well, my theory is where I'm always walking away and leaving the game on idle. And that's one, and also I'm just gonna kill. I'm gonna kill. Yes, bye. Well, you could what? What? I estimated 13 if we're okay. And I barely even farm. Yeah, you pretty much watch a lot of my playthroughs, so... You watch a lot of my playthroughs, so if there's anyone would know why I'm so slow, you would know more than anyone. But I know, I'm a pretty slow... Fuck you. I'm a pretty slow Zelda Classic player. Like, if you compare my playthrough, the way I play, is my style compared to yours. You probably could tell right away, if you look at the way I'm playing, you probably tell what took me much longer than you. Now, what we got going on here? Oh, okay, gotcha. just make sure I got this. Okay. Yeah, the reason why it takes me so long is it's a number of reasons. Like I says, I think naturally I'm just a little bit slower than most people. Like Forbidden City, for example, it's taken me a nice bit of time, and Promised Lands took me over 20 hours to get a true Promised Lands, and so it's just, and like Don Lloyd's demo of the Hero's Memory, it took me over 3 hours to get your that, and a lot of people got your that demo in an hour. So yeah, it's just, I think it's just a way, I don't know, it's weird, huh? It's just the way I'm playing, so I can't really explain it. Okay, so I need to get there. Okay, which one's gonna lead me where I gotta go? Bottom one, from the looks of it. Before I confirm that, I'm going to look at it one more time. So, bottom. Right. Oh. That's definitely the bottom. Oh. Oh shit, did I fuck something up here? Yeah, this. Oh, okay. Thank God. You got the boss key. Now what's the story here? Oh, okay, yeah, I need to get to those rooms. So how am I getting those rooms? Those stairs, I'm gonna assume. Because I can't go there without going all the way down. So where's those stairs? That's not the stairs. There, no, look, no, where is that? No, I'm looking for something. Two screens involved. That room. Wait, what the hell? Okay, there's something. Okay, something along the lines. I had something activated there, so how do I get there again? Started getting a little tired of rooms that are a lot like this, with this combination of enemies with the same kind of. It's just. I think this is the. I think this room is that one that was just too many. She didn't find level 9 that hard, believe it or not. Not this time around, it was. So how do I get in that room? Weird. Oh, that's how. If I go there, the only thing I'm pretty much doing is get myself back there, so. What, that door there? So... I guess... Okay, yes, that's right. Those two things there. I thought you'd been blown up on the bottom. I guess that's pretty inconsistent. I guess, how did I figure that one out before? But no, I see it now. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Now. I'm gonna save and continue. Just make sure that I don't lose anything. And see, I didn't press F3 there, so that time I was gone, then the attack counter's just going this way. That's why my time goes up like it does. Now. That door there. And okay. Thank you. two. Okay, yeah. Yep. Okay, so I got the bottom one going. And okay, fifth back there. So I. Of course, why am I even overthinking that? I turned the yellow block for a reason. Hopefully there wasn't anything in that room that I messed up. Oh! Now what's the shortest path to this? Oh, I can save it. What? Okay, I can just walk up. Okay, perfect. Okay, very good. Don't I have my wallet full, though? Shit, I shouldn't have saved it then. Like, I still got it. Oh, yeah, it doesn't matter. Yes, my wallet's full! I'm not too worried about that one ruby. Good job, well, I have to say then. Ugh. My old mechanical weapon, metal Arrghus. So, why is the item I got in the dungeon no good against some? Is this Arrghus or Petra? I gotta start figuring this boss. They must bounce off or something. Shit. Ugh! One potion? Oh well then.
Hmm.
That was handled poorly. Yeah, that was a bit poor. Okay, that's one reason why I want the bigger wallet. This ain't too rough. I just got to memorize his pattern a little bit better. And now with an extra potion. Because I didn't even use the super bomb, and I could save the super bombs when he's bouncing after me, and that'll wreck him. He won't stand a chance. It'll just wreck him. So if I can get his patron movements down right and watch his fireball, I should be just fine. It's just an oversized fucking patcher stuck in the corner. Thank you. What's that hit? Something super fast is hitting me out of nowhere, and I don't know what it is. I think I was doing pretty good that time too. It just felt like I was doing good. Scratching my neck. Oh my. Yeah, CC gets very quiet. I'm like, they're scratching my neck. You're like, what is he doing, right? Oh my. Need to use super bombs. Nice. Fuck wasting money on that shit. Your victory has netted you a full heart container. Your life gauge is increased by one full heart. He wasn't too bad after all. And I just now noticing the hookshot things on the edge? Oh my. I'm so bad for noticing those things. You got dense far. This goddess jewel lets you release a giant ring of flame. The Benzer do not treat too nicely when you use it. No, it's the neighbor's love, yeah. You try to use that Benzer, it does something very fucking mean to you. Yeah, so there you go. Oh, that's some good. I got 16 cursed skulls. So, there's one for the item trading level when you finish your item trade thing. There's one in the desert level, and one in the sky level. And is there one in the desert itself? Yeah, is there one in the desert itself? If there is, then I'm up to par with those cursed skulls. Yeah, I know. Perfect. The only thing I don't feel that I'm track on is the heart piece containers and everything like that. So, how far am I behind on heart piece containers and everything else? Like, I have 23 hearts. If that's 10 heart rolls, isn't it? Yeah, I think that's 10 heart rolls. So 23 hearts, and I just beat that boss. I must be behind on hearts. Because ever since level 8, I haven't even been touching the overworld. Okay, perfect. Yeah, so what about that? Oh yeah, I guess I get a heart container from every boss in those areas too. So that's one. So that'll be 27 hearts that I have. I got one heart piece container up there. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 11 heart piece containers, I'm guessing. Yeah, so there's 11 heartbeat containers left in the game I'm gathering, because I'm thinking that all four of those levels you just mentioned got heart containers. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and they're leaving 3... 19 left. Oh, so which level... So the mini level and the jungle level don't give you heart containers, is that? I can't man. Well, anyways, I'm gonna save it there now. That's the reason why. See, now it's reasons like this my time's going up too. I could just sit here for minutes and just talk and not even play, right? Especially when I'm concluding. So yeah, I'm gonna save it there for now and end it. So and then I don't know what I'm gonna do yet because I'm starting to pull up on videos. I want to upload videos too. Okay, there's only 2 boss-related heart containers left. Yeah, so that's... Yeah, that's 19. Okay. Ugh. Oh, and I don't know where they are. Okay, anyways, yeah, that's good then. I enjoyed that, so that's... I'm on my next video there now. I'm not sure if I'm gonna... You know what, I want to get out of the way, so more likely I'll be streaming the Jungle Crypt tomorrow. And then it's the good stuff. Well, except I'm not the biggest fan on that. I'm not the biggest fan on Dusty Caverns either. Dusty Caverns is alright. But I really like Echoing Shrine and Starlight Temple. And so I want to get this rest of stuff out of the way first. So yeah, I'm going to save it there now. And more likely I'll play tomorrow. Jungle Crypt. Okay. Thank you for watching. And have a good night. Yeah, but there's Stan, too, and I want every heart I can get for him. So, see you around.